Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello.
Hear the song again.
Hello.
How are you? One by one, or we made like a in a month.
Zitti e buoni.
Zitti e buoni.
Zitti e buoni. Italians win the Eurovision.
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
And German was a disaster. I know.
Yeah.
Good evening, Karin. Buonasera,
Marta. Good evening.
Hello out there. Today we have a great 30-second show together with Steve Lynch, the former guitar player of Autograph. You know that?
Yes. It's fantastic. Yeah. For first, we explain a little bit rules, because I think our audience for this week really forget what we need to talk about. Oh, people, woohoo, where are you? Welcome.
We're here.
Who? Please. Because I don't remember.
Yeah,
okay.
You're more crazy than me, Victoria. Yeah?
Yes, of course.
Are you drawing more mad than me? Well, okay, you can explain the rules. You can explain the rules. Welcome.
It's up to Victoria.
Yeah. All the girls in here have to explain the rules now to Steve and to our audience, please.
Welcome.
Okay, dear audience, tonight we will have altogether fantastic guests, and these guests have only 30 seconds to answer to our questions, and questions will be absolutely different. It can be very sweet, it can be very hard, very sweet, funny, and so on and so on. But idea is that if he don't want to answer for the special questions, we cut his promotional time. Because normally he need to have 2 minutes for promotion. But if he don't want to talk with us and explain something, sorry, we cut everything. But maybe after he can have back if he answered fantastically for some kind of questions. And actually, dear audience, it's for you now a chance to ask your own question to Steve Lynch. And actually, everyone from us have a special role. Now I explain about mine and after we can see you.
Yeah,
I'm, for example, a Beauty and the Beast. I can be very nice and can be very not nice. Yeah. Like now, you know, double personality is very hard, actually. For this, my question can be very beautiful or very not nice. Welcome, York.
Yeah, Fox, and I'm the schoolmaster because of my patented look. You see that for my students and so. And I'm doing questions that need a little bit of thinking about if it is a question at all.
Wow,
Vladimir.
Hi there, my name is Vladimir. I'm from Russia. My name is Vladimir Brilov. I'm supposed to be famous or something like that, singer here in Russia. My role is mystique, because the truth is out there, you know, from Russia with love.
Wow. Okay. In order, it's very easy for me. I'm completely cuckoo. In Italian, it's like I'm completely crazy, but it's nice to be crazy. And for this,
only for you.
Yes, only for me. Maybe
now you'll see this question.
It doesn't matter.
That.
Alessandro, that explains everything.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely. And my questions are crazy like me. Sergio. Yeah.
And I am the bad guy. As you can see, I'm in the darkness because I am a bad guy. I have a dark soul. So my questions will be very hard
stronzone
to answer.
In Italian language, stronzone.
Stronzo means asshole. I am also an asshole,
a little bit, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, come and on. We won't believe you in a lifetime.
And we know if Sergio touches the sunlight, he will burn to ashes.
Absolutely, yeah. That's true.
Really?
That's why I'm wearing a cap since when I wake up.
So we really have a vampire online, right? Right now. For the first time in the online air. Jesus. Wow.
I am a fan of Rammstein also.
Okay. That's
but nobody sees it.
It's time to introduce our guest of tonight.
Yeah.
But we start with a small video of him, because before to hear his voice, it's better to hear his music and how great.
Hi Jay.
Hi Jay. We start with the introduction video. I start. We are ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you hear that? It's fantastic. It is unbelievable. Splendid.
He
marvelous.
Should become a guitar player, I guess.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, you became a yes.
He has talent. Yeah.
Yet.
Okay. Yeah, he has talent. Introduce our guest of tonight. Jörg, it's your turn. No, Jörg.
It's my turn.
Ladies first.
Everybody, like a chorus.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
Please.
Really want to introduce our amazing guest of tonight. It's Steve Lynch. Welcome.
Thank you.
That's
so
right,
much.
Steve Lynch. Welcome. Hi there.
Hi, Steve.
Woo-hoo. Rock and roll.
How's it going in Florida?
It's going fantastic. It's hot as hell down here, but I'm
jealous. Jealous.
Yes. Well, come on, it's getting warm in Russia right now. It's getting warm in Germany. It's getting warm in Norway and Italy.
That's right.
Wearing the shirts now. But in Florida, it's always warm.
Oh. It is. You get a few cold days in the wintertime. Look, like it's cold for about a week.
Describe cold days in Florida. It's 25.
Okay. Victoria, we have to move and then open office in Florida.
Yes.
We should do that. Yeah.
What do you mean cold? It's a simple question from a guy from Russia. What do you mean cold? Exactly. Cold is how much?
He wears t-shirts, but with frills.
Yes. Not minus 40, right?
No.
As we do.
Yes.
Okay, maybe we start with the test, with the first question. Yes?
The test Here's question, Steve. Yeah.
Number zero.
Now ready. You have question number zero.
Ready? Let's
zero question. Wow. And our question, zero question is, introduce yourself. 30 seconds. Welcome.
Introduce myself. I'm Steve Lynch. I was born in January 18th, 1955. And I started playing guitar in 1970 after Jimi Hendrix died. And what I've been doing my whole life has just been playing guitar ever since I was 15 years old. That's the only thing I've ever done. And so that was 51 years ago. And I'm still loving it. And my passion is still there, always will be. And that's who I am. And right now I'm writing a book about my life. And that's almost finished. And I think you'll find it very interesting.
Quite perfect, I would say.
Yeah.
1955, you drink blood of little children.
I do.
How do you look like this?
How did you
Unbelievable.
Know that?
You've thought it. You just thought it. You've told us right now.
Yes.
A kid, man. He's a kid.
So you started playing guitar after Jimi Hendrix died, but not because of
not
you,
because of
coincidence.
I waited till he died so I wouldn't have any competition.
Okay, now he dies. It's my
turn. Yes, I see. Yeah. That's a
I'll do it
strategy,
instead of him.
Mm-hmm.
Seriously, did you get inspiration from Jimi Hendrix?
Yeah, I was really inspired by Jimi Hendrix and Jeff Beck as well. And Jimmy Page and you know, all those guys. The last person I listened to as an influence was Alan Holdsworth when I was going to the Guitar Institute back in 1978. And he was the last guitarist that I really listened to. And that was it. After that, I never listened to guitar players again. As far as being influenced, you know, I hear all these great guitar players, but I don't do anything as far as, you know, getting any influence from them, because I just want to be myself. And yeah, so, yeah.
I understand.
Yeah.
You hear all that guitar players, but you don't give a damn.
Yeah. No, I don't.
Okay.
So, Steve, when you're ready, I have a first question for you.
Question number one with Jörg. Let's get out.
So, what are you irrationally afraid of, and how does it affect your life while this irrational fear is going on?
I don't believe there's a rational fear going on, except for the people that perpetuate it themselves. I look at it like, if you're referring to the whole pandemic thing, I look at it that it's now it's pretty much over, and I'm so grateful for that. And I think that everybody really needs to just think with a positive attitude and just keep going forward with their lives and keep going forward with everything that they're doing, and just think positive. Always think positive.
No. Okay.
So,
those sound effects are great.
Are you satisfied, Jörg?
Yeah.
I would say that fits perfect.
Yeah,
if you only see the positive life side of life, there is no fear.
Yeah.
That's
always
exactly
look
right. Yeah.
On the bright side of life.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that question was always a cake, of course.
Cool.
Okay, time for the bad guy here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I want to see.
Positive bad guy.
So, between Gandhi and Mother Teresa of Calcutta, who would you throw from the tower, and why?
Mother Teresa. The reason being is that I think Gandhi was more, even though Mother Teresa was all-encompassing for all religions and everything, I think that Gandhi really spoke for the people at the time while he was alive. And I think that he was more profound in his wording. And I think that he encompassed pretty much everybody in the world.
So cool. Cool. You would kill Mother Teresa.
What a kind of a cruel guy you are.
I know.
Jesus. What am I doing right here? I thought I'm supposed to be near the greatest musicians of our era. And what do I hear? You threw Mother Teresa out of the tower. My ears are bleeding.
Well, you don't actually prefer Gandhi, Vlad.
I would have thrown myself out of the tower.
Time for this Russian guy to make
Now I'm curious.
Give me one second. I want
to say something.
Okay.
All you people out there, we have a lot of visitors in here. And that's really, really cool. So, again, welcome to the show and enjoy it. So,
are they alien visitors? Alien visitors? I want alien visitors only. Okay.
We only have alien visitors.
Okay.
Yes. There's a question
from Italy. From Italy.
From Italy.
The Måneskin fan club.
Yeah,
Måneskin. Okay, it's time for Vladimir. Vladimir, your question.
First of all, I want to thank all of you for such an honor to be part of this conversation, because I guess for thousands of people who enter our conversation, it'll be a really great show. And as a guy who was born in 1985, with all my respect, and as a mystique from Russia, I want to ask you a simple question.
Okay.
Read it right here. Come on. Okay. What kind of mistake you'll never forgive a woman, and why? Example.
I'd never forgive a woman for being unfaithful. And the reason being is that once you make a commitment to somebody, that should be your commitment to that person for as long as you're together, whether it be for the rest of your life or the duration of the relationship. This being because there has to be a trust built up, and you can't lose that trust, otherwise the relationship is over. So damn it, keep your shit together and be faithful.
Jesus freaking God, that was the most rock and roll answer ever, I guess. According to a relationship between a guy and a woman. I'm pleased, really pleased. That was very useful, I guess, for young people who are with us during this conversation, who are watching this TV show.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah,
it's funny Vladimir. Mr. Lynch didn't have any cut of his seconds, so.
Yeah, Vladimir, you have to know that we guitar players have all the answers.
We do.
You are just well experienced, nothing more. Just tell us. I know that during this script we don't have such an answer, such a question. But just tell me, or show us with your eyes or fingers, how many women you left by during the way to get this knowledge about relationships.
That's a good question.
How many women did I go through to realize this?
I would not answer in your place.
Be careful, Steve. Women are watching.
Okay. Now I think it's time we need to be careful.
I think there was probably
only one. It was your mother.
It was both my hillbilly sisters, actually. No.
Okay. Three.
I would say three different relationships during my whole life. Yeah, where there has been those kind of issues. But you know, we were young and they were stupid. so they made mistakes and they lost me in the process. So c'est la vie.
And you were a rock and roll man.
That's right. Yeah. I'm rock and roll. True. So I don't put up with it. I just move on.
Yeah. Time for the crazy guy. Our crazy boss.
Yeah. 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 Crazy boss. Welcome.
Alessandro.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Hello, Alessandro.
Hello, Steve. It's nice to have you tonight here.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
Okay. We start with this very easy question. Okay. Which is your favorite Italian dish? You have 30 seconds to explain to us how to cook your recipe.
Okay, I would say chicken fettuccine, because I love the noodles. That's one of my favorite form of noodles is the fettuccine noodles. And I like the creamy white sauce, and I think that with the right amount of cook time with the noodles and the right kind of ingredients in the creamy sauce, and with the nice broiled chicken cut sliced thin on top of it, with a lot of Parmesan cheese on top. It's got to be a lot of Parmesan cheese. And that sounds wonderful.
I just
had it.
How does he do this? How does he do this? Second to second. Finally, cut. 30 seconds.
One can do it, the other can't. With all your knowledge, I would suggest you to write a book.
Okay, I'm going to do that. Just because you asked me
about cooking.
I'm going to do that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know,
I feel so honored.
It's going to be called My World with the Strange Jorg from Germany.
Okay, okay, I can live with that.
Okay.
And I'll create a great presentation in Russian, believe me.
Yes.
Marta, our Italian fans asked me, excuse me, so what Italian dish was that?
Fettuccine Alfredo?
Fettuccine
all'Alfredo.
Oh, okay.
Fettuccine all'Alfredo.
Here.
Ha pronunciato fettuccine, molto, molto slang americano, però intendeva
fettuccine Alfredo.
Yes. Okay.
Alfredo, per chi non lo sa, un famoso ristorante qua di Roma, del centro di Roma.
Here. Oh, this is what it is.
Already cool.
Oh, my God.
You was prepared.
It's not looking so catchy.
This is what I had earlier. This was the leftovers. So there you go.
So
there's my favorite right here.
In Russia, this word sounds very hard. Fettuccine. We called it very strongly. Fettuccine.
Fettuccine. Like Chianti. CH is.
Yeah, you must let it roll.
To be perfect, it should be fettuccine.
Fettuccine.
Okay, fettuccine.
Okay. Because fettuccine is male.
So much
they are female. So fettuccine.
By the way, Italian dishes.
But I find that's really intelligent. Hey, Jörg, how do you cook your dish? Oh, I get a telephone and ask the pizza service.
Sì, Sergio, ma le fettuccine col pollo, tu hai mai sentito?
No.
Fettuccine with chicken is quite strange here.
Talking about his own recipe.
Yeah,
why?
You are strange, Alessandro.
Maybe, yes.
We are Italian and we're talking about Italian receipts, so we still are frightened about your, what was, spaghetti with 20
shut up.
Minutes?
Shut up.
Okay.
Shut up. Not
about. Hold on.
Just carbonara.
The sweet Victoria.
But Alessandro is satisfied with the recipe.
Yes,
you don't want to have...
Yes, okay. Fettuccine with chicken is strange, eh?
Yes.
But okay.
Italians are strange.
Okay.
The guys who have made this fettuccine with chicken.
But after Victoria and the salad with, together with cappuccino, I'm ready for everything.
Oh,
salad.
I got dance like sticlataro.
Iced cappuccino. Whoa.
This is iced cappuccino. You have to get iced in Florida. You can't get hot cappuccino.
Ah, iced cappuccino con salata. Okay. Insalata. Sì, perfetto.
Insalata.
Cool.
Okay. Oh, Alessandra, you've told us all these secrets of Victoria.
Incredible.
But I think now is the point to give the word to our beautiful Victoria.
Okay, let's go.
Okay, Steve.
Okay,
I'm
Victoria, let me have
be
it.
Here.
Let me have it. I know you're going
to
ask me a question that I'm not going to be able to answer, but go ahead.
No, you can. Because now from my beautiful side will be beautiful, beautiful questions.
Okay.
Only
okay.
Okay. Tell me, please. What is the color of your soul and why?
It would be blue. Actually, it would be kind of a bluish green, like a turquoise. And the reason being is that blue and green are my favorite colors in nature. I love the color of the sky, the color of the nice ice blue water, and I love the greenery of trees and shrubbery, and just I've always been just a fan. Growing up in Seattle, there was the blue skies. Well, sometimes there are blue skies, but there was just like, and down here in Florida, same thing. The blue skies, blue water, and green trees everywhere.
Zero.
He did it! He did it!
This is a great man.
Wow, so beautiful answer.
Cool. So cool.
Really, yeah. Really, really.
But I would suggest if you look into your referee and you see something from your last dish that's blue, or it has hair, then please don't think you can eat it. You can talk to it, and you can play songs with it, but you should not eat it.
Yes, I've done that on LSD. Actually, I've had good conversations. You know, so
you do all romantic
rock and roll.
You destroy all atmosphere, romantic atmosphere. Yeah.
Okay, next one. Create romantic atmosphere, please. York.
Yes.
Okay. York.
I think I have a cool question for you.
Okay.
It's a question about an actor that once lived. So, you were born as the famous actor Cary Grant. What did you have for breakfast?
I had Tiffany. Actually, I had breakfast at Tiffany's. Okay, that was good. So, yes, I had breakfast at Tiffany's, or I had Tiffany, or whatever. Okay, whichever order you want to put those words in. But yes, I was around the time of Cary Grant and those old actors. So, me and Cary were hanging out at Tiffany's. Actually, there is a Tiffany's right here in Florida. In fact, I go there for breakfast a lot. And that's where we always hang out. Me and Cary Grant, always.
Oh yes. Okay. You really met him.
No, I haven't met him. No.
It's old.
He didn't answer.
If you would have, because the question was, you were born as Cary Grant. So you were born a few years ago, and I'm not sure if you would be able to have a breakfast in age of 169 years.
Yeah, no. If you are a vampire, maybe yes.
He's vampire, he can everything. Absolutely.
By the way, he said only he will go to Tiffany, not about what you should be eating for breakfast.
No, okay.
That's right. That's the first part of his answer. And the second part, Steve is answering all evening long. Steve is answering all the questions very poetically.
I think,
pick up this fact.
Yeah. I think.
Yeah, but for this answer,
you want to cut?
I'm afraid, Steve, but we have to cut a few seconds for this answer.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you live with that?
Okay.
How much? Okay. Jörg, how many
Jörg
seconds?
Use the time.
How much?
10 seconds?
10 seconds.
Yeah. 10 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Fine.
Are you okay with that?
Already.
Yeah.
Everyone. Okay. You can
have it back. If you answer in nice way to the next question, you can have it back your seconds.
Yep.
Okay. And for last question, you can have extra 100 seconds.
Yes, the last question, you can have all your seconds.
You know, Steve, one time you lose, the other time the others win.
Yeah.
And you call him your friends, right?
Yes. Okay, let's go. Next one. Okay.
Vladimir, please.
Dear Steve, according to your answers and the way they are very poetic, as for me, I want to ask you if there was any possibility ever in this unbelievable world. So here is the question. If there was any possibility, with whom exactly of ever known fantastic musicians you'd be happy to talk with?
I would say probably it would probably be Paul McCartney. I'd like to sit down and have a talk with him, and because that's who I was originally influenced by to even start playing guitar and playing music. You know, later on I got into Hendrix, but it was the Beatles, and so I would like to sit down and have a chat with him just about, you know, his whole life and his career. So it would be an hours long conversation, but he would be the one.
Say what?
Great. Absolutely spontaneous.
It's in my heart. Yeah. I put Steve Lynch in. It's in my heart. Here.
What an unbelievable opportunity you have, because nowadays you're in the our technologies and so on. Why don't you do that?
You know what? I will probably have a chance one day. I think that I will. And I've just missed him at a couple places when I lived in L.A. And just by actually minutes, I've missed him. And I was hoping to run into him and meet him, but it didn't work out. There was two different instances where he was like literally just like 20 feet from me. And so, but it just didn't work out. So I'm still looking forward to that day, though. And I'd love to cut a song with him, too. I'd love to bring him.
May I ask you a favor? Just promise not to us, but to yourself, to do it in the next few, maybe 2 or 3 years, because we live in one time. Why not?
Yes, that's right. That's right. Exactly. So I'm ready to go when he is.
I'm very pleased with your answer. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Great.
Okay, we were talking about aliens.
Alessandro, that's your new task. To get
bring him back his 10 seconds. Bring him back his 10 seconds.
Okay, we can bring him back 10 seconds back. Okay.
From Russia with love.
Love.
There you go.
Totally agree. Love, 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 love. Okay, we were talking about aliens.
Oh, yes. Wow. There you go.
Alien.
Time for the question from the bad guy here.
Okay.
Try to convince an alien race to not invade the Earth in 30 seconds. How?
We are actually a peaceful race. It is our governments that go to war. We mean you no harm. We want to learn from you as well as you want to learn from us. So let's get together in peace and have a good conversation and see what's best for both of us in the future, for mankind and for your kind. And I think that that would be the best thing for both worlds. Literally both worlds. And that's what I hope for.
Wow.
Wow.
I love that. From the X-Files. That was
you
perfect.
Guys, you are very, very fantastic guys.
Yeah, but he lied.
Come on, guys. Did you really believe this fairy tale? When alien will come to this earth, they will say, guys, hello there. We're aliens, and we have signed up to TikTok. We know the truth.
Yeah. I think that if...
We're peaceful. Come on.
All we need to do is hand them a joint and say, here, have a hit off of this, and everything's going to be great.
But you lied. We are not
the guitarist's way.
We're not a peaceful kind of people.
Well,
not at all.
If they can kick our ass, we're peaceful.
Not enough. We try.
You're not satisfied, Sergio? You're not satisfied?
No, I am, because his answer was perfect, but he lied a bit, but
so he made it.
Tried to convince.
It's a show.
Who doesn't?
The question was try to convince the alien race, not with telling the truth. So,
yeah.
He lied, okay? He lied.
Okay, I think that we are a peaceful people. It's the governments that make war. It's not the people themselves.
Governments is humanity. Yeah. Is a part of humanity.
That's true.
There is a very famous musician from Norway. His name is Alexander Rybak. He's very young. And to this situation is completely his song. I'm in love with a fairy tale. Blah, 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 blah. I didn't mean to hurt anyone.
No, he just blah, blah, blah.
That beautiful blah, blah, blah. Oh, very beautiful. Wow.
There's a very interesting question now from Victoria. Yes, this is right.
My favorite question. Really, really. Now you need to tell to us all the truth. Okay, question is, imagine you are at the Grammy Award. You are walking on the red carpet and you have only 3 dresses to wear. It's Kermit from Muppet Show. This one. Other, it's dress of hot dog, this one, and dress of sadomaso. What do you choose and why?
I would choose the first one because I want to be the superhero. And besides that, the green clashes with the red carpet. And that's all I want to be. I want to be a superhero on the red carpet. and I want to wear something that clashes with the red, and that would be the first outfit, the green one. And so that would be my choice. And that way, everybody, all the paparazzi that takes pictures of me go, wow, that guy's really original. Look at that outfit. Nobody's ever dared to wear anything like that except for Steve.
Wow. Do you hear the word perfection? You
are perfect. Is not a superhero.
Every question is perfect answer. How it goes. Wow.
Thank you for a good idea for the next ceremony.
And hell yeah, Kermit rules. Muppets rule. Yeah.
<That's right>. Yesterday I used Miss Pinky. Yesterday you were.
That's right. I wear this costume, Miss Pinky.
Fantastic.
How are you talking about the most beautiful woman on this planet, Vladimir?
Miss Piggy.
Piggy is perfect. Yeah. You know?
Completely perfect. I love this character. Absolutely. When I was young. That was one of the first TV show that was shown after the USSR left out on the first channel in Russia. Mm-hmm. And it was shock for everyone.
Why?
Because after Russian cartoons, the Soviet cartoons, which are very about the humanity, the relationships in the family and so on, they are so right, they are so strong and right. They talk proper way. You see the Muppet Show, and you are 5 years old. It knocks you out. Your head is out from your body when you are five. When you are 45, the same thing.
Alessandro, do you remember the Swedish cook from the Muppet Show? Smørrebrød, rum, pam, pam, pam. Do you remember?
I remember Gonzo. You remember Gonzo?
Gonzo, I remember.
Yeah. Gonzo. And the Swedish cook, because I have a 2-meter-large puppet of the Swedish cook here in my house. Next time, I'll bring it to you.
With sandwich. With sandwich, yeah. Smørrebrød is like sandwich in Swedish language, yeah. The same like in Norwegian.
Smørrebrød.
With Steve's book.
Okay, let's move
That's
on.
Right. Time for the last
question. Yes.
Our crazy Italian friend.
We are in the end, but this is nice. This is nice. We will see if we can have more extra bonus second with these questions.
Okay. Yeah, okay. A very nice question I see here.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay, Steve, you are a really fantastic guy, and this question is for you because I want to understand how your creativity could be very, very, very strong. And for that, I ask to you, create for us a poetry about a happy, sexual addicted baboon.
A sexually addicted baboon. Okay. This baboon, you will see, he doesn't have a flea, but he does have a high sex drive. Now, watch out, women, put your kids away and enjoy the ride that he's going to take you on, because it will be the ride of your life. He will take you into the sunset and he will rise with the sunrise with you. This is the second addicted baboon.
Oh, yeah.
Fantastic. I love you, man. Fantastic. I love you, man. I love you, man.
We all love this man.
The question of today is, who is grilling whom?
Yeah, all right.
He is grilling us again.
Exactly. 12 Steve, points go amazing. To Steve. Wee.
Yes.
The only one. The only last question is left out to our audience. Is there anybody not 18 or 21 years old here to hear such an answer about sexual addicted baboon?
Hey, it's too late. Everyone go to sleep. Who don't need to listen? It's okay.
Okay. Okay, indeed, guys.
There is one last question, and this okay. last question we need from you out there. So shoot us a question we can ask Steve. So come on, get your keyboard and write some questions. Come on.
In the same time, when we wait, we are waiting this question, we can, I don't know, maybe Jorg, you can ask something additional to Steve, whatever you want.
Create your question right now.
Create your question right now.
Okay. yes. If you were Kermit from the Muppet Show, and if you were running on that red carpet, what underwear would you prefer to wear?
He made you, man. He made it. Yeah, York.
It would say on my underwear, I am a Muppet with a puppet in my pants. There.
Ah, okay. Like it is in real life.
Sergio, the dark man, are you pleased with this answer?
Well,
it was sleeping.
Looking for messages. Oh, there is a, by the way, there is a
Steve, question. You're the man.
From YouTube.
That's incredible.
Okay. I accept the answer. What?
We have a question from Karen. Okay.
Can you copy a book? Okay. What item would you want buried with you in case you could use it?
Okay, in Italian gesture is like this. Sorry.
Okay.
It's Italian.
Okay.
So, come on, Alessandro, where's the timer?
Okay, I didn't hear the whole question.
What item would you want to have buried with you in case you could use it in the afterlife?
Ah, okay. I would say, of course, my guitar, because eventually I'm going to wake back up and start playing again, no matter where I'm at. That's just what's going to happen. And it would either be, if you go to heaven, you get a harp. If you go to hell, you get an accordion. But I want a guitar. I want to be right in between. So that's what I would want, with a guitar.
That easy. Piece of cake.
Nothing more to say.
That was a fun question from a fan, first of all. What do you mean? Do you have something about accordion, against accordion? My first musician education was accordion.
Oh, you're a Russian.
That's right.
It not dependent on that I'm from Russia.
No, in Italy is the same. You know, accordion.
I guess we'll have a great company in, not there, in there. They'll be
the Russians from hell. I see.
Only with you, York. Only with you. I won't follow that way all by myself. Don't wanna be.
No, Vladimir. You can see I'm a young and innocent little girl.
Oh, mamma mia!
You don't doesn't do this when I ask you when you watch your first porno movie, eh? You remember? Tutti frutti, eh?
We are back. Are we really in the rock and roll show or back to the BBC or CBS? I don't know how to call these TV channels. We're tranny.
tranny.
You're speaking in foreign tongues.
Please. Keep calm now. Eh? We have to return in normal condition.
Not possible.
Breathe. Ready? Because now we have the 2 minutes for Steve Lynch to talk with our audience and try to convince our audience to follow you or say wherever you want.
What's that now? I'm sorry, you were cutting out. Go ahead.
Now it's time for you to say whatever you want. 2 minutes for your beautiful promotion, for your beautiful talking with our audience.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, yes. What I'd like to say, what I'd like to say to the audience is, thank you, first of all, for listening to my music throughout the years. I have more music on the way, and that is from Blue Neptune. And that is a concept album where it's going to have a lot of different ingredients in it. Some things will be more symphonic sounding. Some things will be more world beat. Some things will be very heavy industrial sounding. And some things will be more classical sounding. And I just wanted always to put together an album like that. Something similar to Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon, except for more of a modern day version of it. And I'm writing a book about the story of my life now. It's all the different things that I've been through, you know, since my early childhood. And I think that people are going to find that very interesting because of the fact that there's so many stories that I have, written about all the different experiences that I've been through throughout my life. And I think a lot of people will be surprised about all the things I've been through that don't pertain to music necessarily. And all the travels around the world and the experiences I've had traveling abroad. And I think it's gonna be very interesting for people. And after the book is done, which will be within the next, I would say it would be out in the beginning of July. And then I'm going to start recording for my project, Blue Neptune. And then after that, I plan on writing another book about my thoughts, all the things that I've learned throughout my life and studied throughout my life, like astronomy, like spirituality, like philosophy, and all these different things. And that's going to be a book I'm going to write about all my thoughts. And it's going to be called From the Outside Looking In, because that's what I am. I'm on the outside looking in.
Cool. Cool words.
Cool
words.
It was, Steve, it's such an honor for all of us and for the audience to see you right here, to listen to your thoughts, because I guess everyone who is online with us, who are not only in the online, but who are reading, who are watching, will follow to all your social networks, to all your music, because you are a fantastic musician, but you are a philosopher. That's a great honor for us to be here tonight.
Thank you.
Yes, really, really great tool and great person. Yes. Yeah.
Well, thank you. Thank you for that. I want to share everything that I've been through with everybody out there. I'm not holding anything back in this book. It's all real stories about things that have happened to me and how I interpret them, how it's helped me to become who I am today. And that is somebody that understands and listens to people and wants to help people that are having trouble along the way. Any kind of advice I can give to anybody, any kind of way that I can lift them up when it's a gloomy day, then I would like to be a part of that. And I hope that my words inspire people, and I hope that my music does as well. And so that's what I'm going to continue to do till the day I die.
This is great message. Great message.
Yeah. Great speech. Yeah, yeah.
Beautiful. Really, really beautiful.
They're very sure
I should read your book, but I won't get it off my head to see you in a Kermit costume. Sorry.
No, believe me. I would love to do that. I would do that, yes. As long as I get Miss Piggy, that's the only thing that really matters. I want Miss Piggy really bad. So,
my words.
I'll make a great pair for you on this red carpet of Grammy.
Something you asked me for, only for you, I can show you that. Maybe only for us. We have Miss Piggy.
Yes. I love it.
Kind of Miss Piggy.
So hot.
So kind of.
Absolutely hot.
God, wow. Please that make this no copy. One from Russia have ever heard this conversation.
It'll be on Spotify tomorrow.
So. That's right.
I can't everything.
I can imagine tomorrow's newspapers signed up with Brilliant and Miss Piggy. Why not? Who cares?
You should move to Florida. So
yes.
Yeah. No, with I Miss love Piggy. Russia. I love Moscow. Thank you for making such a book, because very few of legendary musicians have ever made such manuscripts for the audience, because everyone who listens to your music will have so many questions to ask to you, and you give them answers before they ask them.
Yes. Well, that's, you know, and anybody that has any questions about my life in general, just read the book. You get everything right there. Yeah. And so... it's all laid out there, and it's been a work in progress. But I've been spending almost every single day for the past year writing away about 6 or 7 hours a day, and so it's been a real challenge. But I love the fact, because it's something different. I've never done anything quite like this. Like I mentioned before, I've written 3 instructional books, but never anything like this. And it's kind of prompted me to want to write another book in the future, like what I was just talking about. So
yeah. You could answer to all this question that never been asked.
Yes. That's right.
And for next show, we need to read book first, and after we really need to think what type of questions. Oy, oy.
Yes.
But okay.
Yeah. And we, yes, but this is true. Yes. When book will be released, we have to invite one more time Steve, because
promotion.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we want to...
This way you can look at a couple stories and you can ask me about the stories and we can talk about that and everything. But there's so many stories in it. There are so many things that people, you know, they just don't realize, you know, because I've always kind of been in the shadows. You know, I haven't been out a lot in front of the public, you know, because I'm kind of a recluse. I mean, everybody says with the COVID-19 thing, stay home. I'm going, well, that's what I do anyway. I mean, nothing changed about my life. I'm still just the same. So nothing changed at all. Except
Alessandro, I have the feeling that was a trick. I think you only want Steve to read his book for you here in the show.
There you go. I'm probably going to have to do an audio version of it, so it might be me speaking on the audio version.
Yes, the radio drama.
Yes, that's right.
Steve, please don't do this. Please don't do this in this show, because if you'll do this in this show, you must rename the book. It will be named something like 3 Little Affairs, Blue Neptune, and the Stuff.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Right now it's called
Alessandro, can we have a new host from Russia, please?
I love this guy. I love
York,
this guy.
York, get lost, get lost, get alive.
Bye bye.
Guy, I say thanks to all of us, because all of you, because it was very nice, no worries. And I really loved the attention and the what we have. This show is very funny and very positive, and think
yes, absolutely,
we need to continue with this this idea, because it's we need some funny time and
absolutely. I love the concept. I love the concept of the whole show. It's fun. It's funny, and it's just a gas to do. So I'm really glad to be a part of it. Thanks for having me on.
No, it was a pleasure. And now people know better about you. Also, Italian audience know more deep what you are. Not only like musician, but like person. And this, I think, it's really, really important.
That's right.
And they know what they have to cook tomorrow.
Yes, maybe not for cooking, maybe.
Fettuccine,
maybe.
Fettuccine, sorry. Fettuccine. There it
is. Lots of people in Russia renew you, Steve, not only as a legendary musician, but as a very interesting person.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Well,
and hopefully
my book will be released there, which I'm sure it will be. Well, I have a lot of friends in Russia.
We'll be waiting. We'll be really waiting to read it.
Yeah.
And now we have new friends from all over the world you can visit when you travel. You can go in Italy, in Russia, in German, in Norway.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I'm sure there will be a book. There will be a book tour. I'm not sure whether it'll be set up yet. That's yet to be discussed with the publishing company. So, but I'm sure there'll be a book tour, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm actually timing it pretty good, because of the fact that now that the pandemic's pretty much, sliding away, which is a good thing, then it'll become time where I can actually travel and be around people. And so it'll be good timing for the release of the book and a book tour.
So, absolutely.
Yeah.
I cross fingers.
So, yes. Nice.
Me too. Yep.
Everyone.
Here, cross all your fingers like that.
Cross all your fingers. Also this finger.
Hey, here.
Vladimir, which type of socks you have? Green socks?
I don't want to know.
These are Kermit socks. You're Kermit socks.
Come on, I'm Mystique from Russia.
No, you're Kermit.
The Russian Kermit.
So, Steve, I will be the Kermit, and you'll be Mrs. Piggy.
I'll be it. Here you go. See,
I'll be monster. So.
Вот в таком варианте это в России можно пустить в эфир. In this variety, we can show it in Russia.
Yes, Vladimir, you have to know, we guitar players, we can be whatever we want.
That's right.
Even a bass player.
What a free guy! What a free guy you are!
Okay, guys.
Amazing.
We finish with another video from Steve.
Just last word from everyone who want to say something.
Steve, brother, thank you for
being
in the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. This was really, really a lot of fun, and of course, I'll be back on your show many times, Jorgen, and I just want you to know that I really appreciate the opportunity. Yeah, thank you so much.
You are
really
great.
Yeah. You're so amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah, any last words from Russia?
Yeah.
Don't be jealous. Don't be jealous, Germany. Steve, that was a great trip for me. A splendid trip for me and for all the audience to find another friend in Florida.
Well, thank you.
And I guess that not only me, but everyone who is watching this show right now will be really waiting for your book.
Just to read it.
And I guess there'll be a great number of thoughts to think about.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you for it. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay.
Sergio, guys, last word.
It's time for video.
No, it's time for me. It's time for me.
I said. Sorry.
It's always.
I give you my time, Victoria. No, never mind.
Every time.
I give you my minutes.
No, you, Sergio, I'm the last one.
No, I don't want to say anything. Okay. Just love.
Okay, thank you so much to everyone. Thank you so much, Flo, for Vladimir, because tonight he was first time in our international team. And I hope you enjoyed, because especially for me, it was perfect. I really like it.
Thank you very
much. Steve, I want to tell you a truth. It's a secret. First time when we create the show, 30 seconds, no one knows it. Almost 30 seconds. And I say to York, I want in our show, Steve Lynch. I want. And York, okay. I think he wanted because he's a superstar. I say, no, I want because he's amazing, amazing person. And this is totally true. Because I talked with Alessandro after shows, and it's like, you know, I very like Steve Lynch because this energy, this kindness, intelligence,
vibration.
I like, wow. Really, when I have the first show with York's World Alive with you, like, wow, he's so nice person. Absolutely. If you don't talk, you know, you can feel this vibes and then you are super gentle and super, super nice person. I'm really, really glad that we have this possibility
to
talk with you. It's so nice. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for that. That's so sweet.
True.
Thank you.
Thank you for this soul enlightenment for us.
Oh, there you go. I love that.
That's always such a great moment. When she was asking me,
and the Oscar goes to
Yar, can you please ask Steve? Okay. I'm always so expressive and emotional.
Oh, there you go.
Like a German guy.
Great.
Alessandro, any last words from Italy?
Allora, from Italia io dico, italiani, questo uomo è fantastico, già li voglio bene, this man is fantastic, I love him, and invito tutti gli italiani ad andare ad ascoltare un po' di musica degli Autograph, musica anni 80, rock di una volta dove si suonava davvero. Adesso che sta tornando rock anche in Italia con i Maneskin, sentiamoci anche da dove il rock è partito, ok?
It's I agree with everything you said.
No, yep. In Italy we start to have a new generation of rocker, and this is nice, and for that, yep, we have to listen from who the real rock create and play during this fantastic time of rock and roll from the 60s until now.
Yeah,
and for that, today we have a great performer and guest, and yes, great performer of this era, of a really guitar era and rock and roll star.
Oh, well, thank you for that. Yeah. I can't wait to get back to Italy. I can't wait to visit Moscow. I can't wait to go to Norway. I can't wait to get
eat
back to Germany, because I have to see all you guys.
Okay, let's go. I love you guys.
Bye-bye.
People out there, bye-bye.
See you next time.
Thank you for
watching. Guys.
See you next time in 30 seconds.
Bye-bye.
Okay, the next thing you're going to hear is the thing I did on the second album. It's a solo called Hammerhead. This is what it sounds like.